Let's go. Hello and welcome to a little bit of One Versus One. This is One Versus One between me and Domino. And I think this was a very nice game, so I'm gonna show you the replay of it. I'm human, he's Night Elf, and we have some observer spots, and that's why I'm gonna use the observers. So, yeah. Let's go. Domino starting off with very safely Ancient of War creep here. Even very far away from this. So, I got the... yeah, pretty common, and I block off my base here very nicely. And this layout is very good. So, yeah. A little bit of chatting between one of the observers and Domino, because I think Domino crushed the other guy here, named Cultio. I think he's also a very good player. So, I'm starting off with an Archmage, and he's starting off with a Demon Hunter. So Demon Hunter is gonna come out. Demon Hunter versus Archmage. Archer is coming out, so he will have easy times, because Demon Hunter, you know what it does. Mana burn, mana burn, mana burn. But I also got my first footman out. Domino is starting to grip the spot. He doesn't really use a wisp or something, just eating trees, and he can easily grip this bot. So he's gonna pick up the item and straight run to me. This is what only Night Elf can do. And still finishing the creep while harassing me. But I'm pretty good here. I'm using 5 militia to creep this as fast as possible. And I finished it right before he's coming. But this water mantle is very low HP, and he will get it with a detonite of a wisp. And mana burning and or click on Archmage. So nothing I can do there. But I'm gonna just add some more footmen to try to run away from the Demon Hunter. Now he gets some free hits. And another mana burn, so my Archmage will never get a water elemental back out. While he is taking and building another Moonwell and building some more Archer. And I really got a lot of damage here from the Domino. Domino's Demon Hunter. So, but I'm sending Militia now. I think I sent like 7 militia. I tried to surround him, but he reacted so fast, so no chance to surround him at all. So I'm gonna send off 2 of my footmen on the Demon Hunter, so if he wants to stay around here, he will get damaged. Even 3 footmen there, and creeping this only with militia. I desperately wanted to surround him, but he's just all-clicking on my Archmage, so I need to run in circles. And now he's gonna steal the item, a Circle of Nobility, a very nice item for him. So another mana burn, but I finally got my level 2, so Brilliant Arrow should come in a second. And now he's trying to kill some peons. And finally, yeah, I get this one creep here, so very well done. But I get away with my expansion. I still have like 5 peons and another mana burn. So no water elemental for ages. And I'm gonna start to build up my expansion. And of course, you know what to do now. My Archmage is very low. He's sending in some archers. He gets boots of speed. And I don't have dust or something to do to deal with this archer, so not good for me for now. And with his boots of speed and the stuff of teleportation, he will do this famous stuff and stuff trick, you know it. Stuff of preparation and stuff of teleportation to get the fullback Demon Hunter. But I already pulling a shop here, and even I don't know what this person is doing there. But oh, now he's focusing my footman there a little bit, and of course hiding here. And I don't really think I can escape from this one, but now he's blocked with his own archer. But I think if he moves his archer, he still can get out, and of course my archmage is gonna die. I was thinking about TPing there, but I was thinking, no, my archmage is so low HP, if he dies I don't care. And also I sent the footman to scout here, he's getting his Engine of Lore, so I think I killed like one or two wisps with that footman while he was just harassing me, though that was good. This archer still chilling there, and I teched really, really greedy there with like only one arcane tower for the defense, but I got a good chunk of footmen to defend. My archmage still taking some time, and this peons are gonna kill that tree. Now I'm getting some defense here, another tower, and he's coming just within zeros, and he will do a lot of damage with all these zeros. Thank God I got the arcane tower that is burning all of his mana away, but a lot of misses coming out of this one. So good mana burn on the panda here, he's really getting away with murder here, but finally I'm gonna get some towers up, and I think my archmage should be out right about now, getting a clarity, because I have the shop. And Domino is already making a counter expansion, so finally he's backing off, and I will creep this little green spot here. I'm gonna get some towers at my main, and also three towers at my expansion. So expansion is up from Domino, so he can if he wants to get his natural, but now he's equipping the middle spot, which is very nice for him because he will get a lot of experience and a very nice item from the ogre. And I will find this archer and probably kill it. I don't really think he's care about it, so he get a wand of mana stealing. That's a okay-ish item. I don't really think that's good, but it's some money. So I wanted here to get my level 3 now, since his hero has already reached level 3 and his second hero is already on level 2. So I got my level 3 here, no ton of experience so far. And yeah. Die Streitkräfte eines Spielers werden angegriffen. A little bit of creeping from Domino. He's really got the best spots here from the map, so huge advantage to him. And he's slowly moving his engine of his tree of life to the expansion. And I'm gonna get my blacksmith ready. I got about four towers, so this is really nice. Mountain King should be out soon. So I finally have some two heroes to do something. And he's already starting this creep. Got a bunch of dryads for dispel. That's also very good for the Night Elf player. He knows exactly what to do. So he gets another circlet, so very nice items for him. And my Mountain King wanted to go there because I rallied my pointers. So I'm gonna get the Yarf style pullings. Two arcanes and one workshop. This is pretty good, I think, versus Night Elf. And his expansion will go up shortly. while I have mined about 3k gold there, but I'm gonna create my mercenary camp, which will give me a huge chunk of experience. And but he's pushing in a very good timing in. He doesn't have monster bears, by the way. I'm not sure if he did forgot about this monster bears, but he's doing a good chunk of damage because I was focusing on my creep, so I didn't repair. I really should do this repair shit, and the Breath of Fire really killed like all of my peons. Finally I'm here, and I even sending a chunk of militia here to my expansion. So that's a very crucial fight, and without the help of militia I think I would have lost that, but I really did send them in. So MK is in a spot of trouble. I tried to micro him back, but the militia are blocking him and Mana Born finishing off. So another Breath of Fire really hurts a lot of my peons. But since I'm supply stuck, almost it's not so bad to lose a few workers. And the first mortar team and the first swords and priests are out, so I'm doing a lot of damage to these dryads. And his panda is really getting away with 30 RP. One more hit would kill him, but I lose track of the site because of the nighttime, and he even stuffs him out. And now he's gonna probably try to kill those mortars off. And I'm still on 50 supply, so even I lost like 11 militia down there. And my MK doesn't really want to join the fight. So, yes, Spellbreaker really doing a good job by taking off the Rejumination, and finally he backs off. He did a lot of damage there. But I think if I would have had more formers, and I could have easily defended it. But also, this was not so bad for me as you think, because now I have a lot of food space for my army, so I don't really need to go into upkey. And he got the like four bears ready, and more bears are coming. Expansion is almost full. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get the sexy scrolls, which all humans love to get. And I get even booth scrolls and the invo pot, so I'm very good to go. And also my bank is very high because of all the time not going into upkeep. But his army looks far stronger than mine, so I decided to retreat a little bit of, taking a little bit of damage here. He's gonna get the water elemental, and still wants to try to push in without dryads. Now he wanted to get, I think, also the scrolls, but I already pulled them. So no scrolls for you. And I'm getting prepared. I'm pulling some more forms. I'm, force pulling them even. I'm getting out a lot of mortals, some spellbreakers. Just waiting until my army is strong enough to take care of him. But this is very interesting now. He bought the invisibility potion. So my view was like here, micro, micro, micro. And while I'm doing this, he's just wrapping apart my economy. So the fight is continuing. He doesn't have twice for the slow. But in this fight, I really look like only here, and he's destroying my economy with the panda. I have two heal scrolls, and I'm just microing like mad, doesn't want to lose anything. I think I killed even some units and he killed like nothing. I just was about to use my first heal scroll, but then he TP'd out, and I also had a regeneration scroll, so that's very nice. And then I looked at my expansion and whoa, holy fuck, what the fuck did happen there? But I had like four peasants on wood, though, no problem to get this back. And now my army looks very good. I even get the upgrades. 70 food. But he's also, I think, about 70 food, so I don't have a big advantage by the food. He's even gonna creep the small green camp level 4 or level 4 of heroes, almost level 5, so he also got stronger heroes than me. Level 4 and level 1. But I think my army now is a little bit stronger than his. Because I just had to use a regeneration scroll and I still have 2 scrolls of healing. And he has like only 1. So he's trying to defend his expansion. I take down the Entangled Goldmine. I really focus his Demon Hunter since he's so far ahead and looks like he doesn't have a staff on the Panda. So, wham! Demon Hunter goes down. Level up for a Mountain King and I even got some more scrolls. So this is very looking good for me. So no more mana burn and he's trying to get rid of my mortar teams while the focus is switching on to the panda. It's panda getting slow. Panda goes down. Oh my god, this is so good. And now he's trying to retreat. I'm using one of my heal scrolls. And I still think he's got... I didn't kill a lot there. And on wise, he's gonna revive both of his heroes from the Taurans. This is so expensive. So I'm gonna take his expansion down. And Mountain King almost is on level 3. I'm gonna get this bear for free. So this should give him level 3. There we go. Level 3, very important. So I have the advantage in this game right now. Unbelievable. So, wisps are gonna detonate, and I'm even gonna get one wisp here. And yeah, I was so strong. I think I was nearly 80 food, and he's gonna report 2 moon worlds. He's at 63 food, so that hurt him a lot. Also, 60 claws plus 9 doing a good job, so I'm gonna push in here. I'm gonna get down the Engine of Wind. He's still gonna regenerate some mana points. And when I see this, I'm probably gonna hit with my Stormbolt. Yeah, I really don't want him to mana up, so Stormbolt, easy Khadgar. Now he got 2 Fairy Dragons. This will hurt me a lot. So he is gonna push in. I still gonna Orclick on his Domino. Demon Hunter, I wanted to say so, but this Fairy Dragon doing a very good job, so I retreated a little bit here. Repositioning my casters in the back there. He is trying to get to these casters, but I was aware of that. I sent my Mountain King down there, and I'm gonna probably use this Heal Scroll. But this was not a good use from the heal scroll because the spellbreaker didn't got healed up. So I'm gonna get the Pandarian Blue Monster again. But the army of Domino looks very much stronger than mine. But I'm still gonna keep fighting there. I think if I would stay in this fight, I could have ended right now. But I was afraid of the fairy dragons and I TP'd out. So he's staying at 34 food and I'm at 52 food and I think I slacked a little bit in my macro as you can see at the Arcane Sanctums. I'm pumping out like mad. And he lost his expansion, he lost his Panda and Brewmaster. And now I'm sending my Archmage directly to the shop to get the next group of scrolls. He even gonna sell something to get one of the scrolls. I also got one of the scrolls, so it was pretty okay. And he just will outclick on the Archmage. I don't have boots, so I'm sending my army right here, but he's retreating, so good for me. But I need to heal up now. I think he wanted to get the second heal scroll, but I had it already, so, and the invoke pot, I think. So, level 5 in the Hive, Archmage level 4, Mountain King, with 2 Invo pots, very tanky. I'm getting Gyrocopters now because of the Fairy Dragons. And I'm just waiting a little bit for my Oni to come in. I even scouted with a Gyrocopter if he's taking another expansion here, but he doesn't. So I'm just getting ready to push in, heal up, mana up, get my Soros, get my Coster ready, get the Gyrocopters ready. 69 food, still a very good bank of gold. So I got about 3 Gyrocopters for the Fairy Dragons. This will help a lot. And Archmage has 1 Heal Scroll. Mountain King even got the Heal Potion. So I'm looking very good and very strong right now. And he wanted to get another scroll, but I also wanted to get the scroll, and he's gonna meet up with my army mana burn, my Archmage. And yeah, shit, but I think no scrolls were available, so I didn't buy anything. And now his Demon Hunter is coming in again, Stormboard slow, but he's also having a Panda in place to staff. And I was afraid a little bit here, but I shouldn't be. So I get some upgrades, I think. Yeah, some more upgrades for my Spellbreakers. I'm sitting at 67 food, and I still have a very good bank, but I got some lumber problems. I even think I got the lumber upgrade there. And now I'm gonna spend my money into Tome of Retraining, which is very good versus bears. Level 3 Blizzard, so no more Dispel. Because I really was afraid that he's gonna get level 6 heroes and wrap me with it. So I even gonna buy a TP, so I'm really ready now to go. And I think my army looks very, very strong by now. The main gold mines run out, by the way, so he just will mana burn my MK. I'm trying to surround him, but Steph, no problem. So I'm sitting here now, because I was scouting his expansion a little bit, so I didn't really wanted to push in into the Moonworlds, but he's going all in now with all of his Wisps coming and the Tree of Life. And I even invisibility my Mountain King said he can't get mana burned. So Fairy Dragons in a very good spot. I sending back my Costas. Gyrocopters doing a good work here on the Fairy Dragons. Big mana burn here. First Heal Scroll is gonna get used. Blizzard on all of these bears. He's also using his Heal Scroll now. Lots of Dispel and mana burn from the Wisps. Big Breath of Fire, but another Heal Scroll is getting used by me. So the Fairy Dragon are dead now, and I even used another Blizzard here. Now both of my heroes are out of mana, as well as to the casters, but I still have a lot left here. I got my peons down there, and this looks very, very good for me right now. He's out of gold, his Tree of Life is coming to get the gold mine, but I won't let him happen that the panda is getting away with like 30 OP. And I'm gonna kill the mine. Still have 2 mortar teams. 1 roar gives him plus 15 damage, that's very good. And I'm also building now an expansion at this expansion point now. And another mass detonation. So his Tree of Life will go down. a very good Breath of Fire, killing a lot of one Mortar team and three Paeons, I think. And my heroes are constantly out of mana. Panda almost on level 6 though. Even the Demon Hunter is almost on level 6. I tried to surround his Demon Hunter. I got the surround, but he's getting away. And I was just about using the Invo Pod, but I don't really want to waste it. Level 6 Archmage. So I just wanted to get up the expansion, heal up, and then I would finish him. But wow, I defeated Domino. Holy shit, how did that happen? It's a 60% Knight of Gore guy. In a very nice game, GG. And wow, GG, I would say. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed. Press the like button and please follow me on Twitch. I will restart the stream for the another replay and see you in a second.